This poor tuner tried to leave the bus lane, but he was waved back because they want to ticket him before they kick him out. Hazard lights again. The reality is that everyone will give you a reason, everyone will give you an excuse for being in the bus lane. And if you give it to everyone, well, there'll be no organization on the road. Everyone will just take you for a fool. There's the license. Issue the ticket, send them on their way. I see a bus, I see a car, I see an MC. A motorcycle just turned around and sped the other way in the bus lane. Nearly didn't stop. Why did you go so fast when the enforcer already gave you a heads up to slow down and pull over? Ah, this is the guy. This is the one that turned around and tried to run the other way. My gulai. They actually crossed the street thinking that he found a way out and they were going to try and apprehend him when he come past. But he went head on with a car or a bus, so he had no choice but to turn around, come back, and then be apprehended. And on the other side, you'll see another private vehicle, although he does have a sign in his window that says government employee shuttle service. Maybe it's true, maybe it's not. A lot of people put stuff on their windscreen that it's just a lie, especially if they want to use the bus lane. I've seen that a lot. The idea of the bus lane is to provide an express route for commuters, an organized route to beat the traffic and to promote commuting. But in fact, well, some people just try to abuse it for their own personal advantage. And I can see another motorcycle behind this bus. He must be thinking, oh my goodness, what's about to happen? Oh look, he's gone to the inside. Maybe he thinks they won't notice him if he goes to the far inside. The bus driver is helping though. He slowed down on purpose so that the motorcycle doesn't have the advantage of speed. So they'll pull that rider to the side and then issue a ticket. This one's going pretty fast. I hope he slows down. They're asking for his license now. It's hard to escape when this barrier's here. You might be wondering, why did they remove the barriers from the flyovers and tunnels? It was for safety reasons they had to remove them, unfortunately. I always have doubts when I see vehicles with magnetic stickers that say police, because the PNP already admitted there are people using those when they're not really a police car. I wasn't able to turn my camera on in time, but there was a private vehicle in the regular lanes and he was giving big thumbs up to the team. I'm guessing he's one of the people that's fed up with seeing people feeling VIP abusing the bus lane. Oh, that's a nice van, but looks like it's got private plate. Same with the one behind. This one turned off his hazard lights once he saw the enforcers. And look at that, my goodness. There's a lady rider who flagged down here also. What they do is they ask him to remove the license from the holder just so there's no accusation later that something else was in there and was taken. Honestly, I think a lot of these drivers won't care about the penalty because it's not that expensive, but the time of going to get their license and then the hassle of being stopped in the bus lane, that's what will bother them. There's another rider that was flagged down there. If you're wondering why the enforcer has his head under there, he doesn't want the ticket book to get wet. They're still waiting for the driver of this car to hand over their license. Things really got out of control. Do you remember when Bong was on EDSA, assigned to EDSA? And some people said, oh, Bong is too strict. It's too much. Oh, what happens if you're not strict, right? Mayhem. Everybody just does whatever they want. I guess it won't be long before we see traffic come to a complete standstill. Because when the rain comes, a lot of riders obviously like to stay under the footbridges, inside the tunnels. I saw a video the other day, the driver was going along EDSA, entered the tunnel and he nearly hit a motorcycle because he was just sitting inside the tunnel, didn't even have his lights on. And of course he didn't have a raincoat, that's why he's hiding in the tunnel. Not sure what they're saying, I saw them trying to wave something at the enforcers. Definitely not a bus, or maybe that's a new type of bus, maybe I'm just bubble. And let's go back in time and take a look at the bus stop where I was this morning. So that's why it's dark, because it's still early morning at that time. And in fact, they just saw that guy get off the bus, climb over the barriers, and I assume that any moment now he's going to run across the busy highway. There you go. And if you hit that person, you'll be arrested for reckless imprudence. So bad luck, drivers. See, the Tahoe man is much older, still managed to take the footbridge. For those people who truly have difficulties, senior citizens, PWDs and such like, they can be assisted to cross a ground level by an enforcer. A bunch of ladies stopped a moment ago and they were thinking about crossing the road, but they read this sign and they took the footbridge. So some people are really obeying the sign, and that's for their own safety, right? If you get hit on EDSA, it's not going to be a good day for you. And here's something that a lot of people have been saying, that the buses should have doors on the left. And as I've been telling people, many buses were already upgraded to have doors on the left and the right for the EDSA busway. Now that the MMDA SCOG team are here, I assume they're going to clear those people that are sleeping and selling candies and cigarettes here in the busway. The problem is having people hang around the busway. Sometimes they're part-time vendor, part-time barker, part-time pickpocket or snatcher. And I'm not saying they're all like that, I'm sure it's a minority. But when you have people hanging around the busway for a long time, you can't tell who is who. Who's the good guy, who's the bad guy? That's why I was thinking it's probably a good idea to enact an ordinance that prevents loitering in the busway. So unless you have a good reason to be here, you shouldn't be here. And remember, you're not allowed to smoke in public transport terminals. So if you're selling cigarettes here, there's a high likelihood that someone is going to smoke. And there you go, one of them has been awakened. The other one was already woken up earlier. Actually, I was surprised when the guy woke up, he took cash out of his pocket and it looked like he had at least 3,000 pesos. So I was surprised, he must be saving for something, I guess. One of the guys woke up, he was walking normal. And then when he saw other people, he started limping. And it reminded me of something we saw before, where an alleged snatcher was in the busway and he was also pretending to be limping and on crutches. And then he pulled out a knife on iAct. I can't post the video footage here because I already got in trouble for doing that before. So I'll just post a photo in the comment section to remind you about that. That guy there has been running back and forth across EDSA. That's what happens when you let people use the center island, right? They'll sleep here, they'll eat here, they'll drink here, and they're just running back. And they'll just run back and forth across EDSA for their own convenience. What you often see is the motorcycles tailgating the buses. And then once they see enforcers up ahead, they'll leave the bus lane. And then they'll argue, I wasn't in the bus lane, I was just riding the line. No, you're in the bus lane and you're using it as a VIP express lane, and then you're coming up with excuses when you get caught. That's the truth. There used to be barriers or bollards everywhere, but then they had to remove them from the flyovers and tunnels for safety reasons.